I'm Judy Becker, and I was a production designer on Carol. In my opinion, the production designer is responsible for creating the world in which the movie takes place. That is, the sets and everything you see on screen that the characters are moving through, that's part of the production design. It's my second time working with Todd. I did I'm Not There, which was this Bob Dylan biopic, which was an amazing experience. And he's a director that I've literally wanted to work with since I began working in the film industry. It was about the time he began working in the film industry. Todd brings so much to the table. I mean, he is a fully rounded filmmaker, and he comes with this book of visual ideas, and we talk about photography and what the New York City of our movie is going to look like. It's going to look like the New York City of Saul Leiter, but it's going to also have these elements, and it's just an ongoing discussion. Carol takes place in 1952 into 1953, and this is not the 1950s that people ordinarily think of, the Eisenhower era, with very bright colors and turquoise and pink and happy, sunny nuclear family. It's the post-World War II 1950s, so it's almost like the 1940s. And we wanted to go for a very naturalistic, realistic, gritty look, really something that would ground the story of these two characters, using a limited color palette, but a realistic color palette, and very much capturing the tone and feel of New York City at that time.
Miss Belovitt, you need it upstairs. Make it snappy.
This movie has to create a reality that draws the audience in so that they're forgetting about the production design and they're thinking about the characters.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
In a lot of the scenes, we have either a limited color palette, something very true to the period, a lot of greens and neutrals and these sort of dirty pinks, or we have very few colors.
What's this all about?
In that world, Carol's red lipstick and red fingernails really stand out, as does Therese's red and yellow hat.
Yes, that's it. Thank you.
If there'd been a lot of other bright color in the movie or in those scenes, they wouldn't have stood out.
Is this you?
Mm-hmm. So in a way, you use color and design to draw attention to the things that you want the audience to be drawn to without it being too obvious. The toy department was a very big set and something that had a lot of moving parts. And we were working on that from the very, very beginning, and before the beginning of prep. One of the things I do is I make a huge wall of visual reference, like what did train sets look like in 1952? That's something very specific. But then the visual reference that's more interesting is what's the look of the movie? And so we started off with looking at certain photographers, and then you put that all up on a wall and you look at it, and there's Therese's world, and there's Carol's world, and there's the road trip, and they all have a slightly different look, and you put that together, and that gives you a sense of the color palette of the movie, of the kinds of locations we're going to look for in the movie, and the feel of the movie. And then I start having color samples made, and we line those up to sort of figure out the palettes, like 10 variations on the same shade of green, fabrics that we would pair with those. So our whole art department office was filled with these samples. It's actually really beautiful looking. Usually when I see a movie that I've worked on, I'm mostly focusing on my work. It's hard not to. I'm looking at it, what would I have done differently, what would I, you know, and it's hard to watch a movie, but when I saw Carol, I was really blown away. I was so happy. I thought, such a great example of how the crafts can work together, you know, and that's what I love about my favorite movies. You know, it was amazing. So moments like that, you know, they're what we live for, I think.